What is going on, Alpha Hunters? Hope you guys are doing well. This is a very nice Wednesday because the account's looking pretty good as we saw some pretty good bearish action today coming after the Fed gave us their announcement on raising rates by 75 basis points. So we'll talk a little bit about that and kind of my outlook. But the reason why I'm doing this on Wednesday this week is I will not be around Thursday and Friday to do live streams or my weekly outlook for Saturday. So I'm going to put this out now, just kind of give you my ideas of what's kind of going forward into the latter part of this week and actually early next week. Then I'll be back in the live stream early next week. And actually the 2 weeks after that, I don't really know if I'm going to be around to be able to do anything. I'm going to try. I'll also be traveling for the beginning part of October. So I'm going to try and figure that out. But let's just kind of get into today. I'm going to try to keep it short as possible. Just kind of run through what you need to know. All right. So let's just look here intraday. Let's just go to a 15 minute. Kind of briefly talk about what went on the beginning part of this week. Okay, so the 19th Monday, you know, Friday, you know, we had the big gap down. We kind of just hung out a little bit of trade higher Monday after a very bearish week the week before. Monday we just had a little bit of a gap down, especially since we closed below the 390 level, and you see that we haven't gotten back to that level and really over it. So that's still not good for the bulls out there. But we saw some pretty good buying that came in on Monday, choppy sideways, and then continued buying kind of into the close on Monday. Tuesday, another little gap down, choppy, basically for the most of the day. A little bit of a breakdown later in the day, took out Friday, Monday lows, and then kind of rallied in a little bit into the close, a little bit of selling kind of came into the close. Nice little gap up today on Wednesday, okay? And then, Fed day, it was going to be choppy. Everybody, this is why the market hasn't really moved a whole lot all week. Everybody's been waiting for Wednesday. Wednesday afternoon, Fed gave us their rate hike decision and their press conference on, like their thoughts and what they expect kind of going forward and their game plan. So we just chopped around before. And then obviously you see right here, right at 2 o'clock Eastern time, the market just kind of got crushed, went out, took the weekly lows actually on that first 5 minutes. We just kind of hung out there for about 15 minutes and then started to slowly climb higher, took out the daily high and weekly highs actually. And if we just quickly look at a daily picture, this is why the market needed to break over that 390 level to get back over that, to really establish the bulls were in control. But that 390 level was very key. And really all we did was just kind of retest a little bit higher into that 389, 390 zone, which was the zone I was kind of looking for a little bit more for that retest. I was kind of surprised we didn't get there Monday. And I didn't really know if we'd get there because I thought maybe Monday was the high that of the retest that we got. But no, we retested a little bit higher as the Fed chairman was talking on his press conference. We got up to about the 389, a little bit over that level. And then slowly just started breaking back down, traded back lower, and ended the day really bearish. I mean, just look at that. I mean, just all the way, just selling right into that last second close. The low and the close are the same penny. It's 377.39. So usually if you get a perfect shave bottom like that, it's going to go lower. It's going to break that low. But it's also kind of like an exhaustion type of indication. So I don't know how much farther we continue to go. And really kind of my thoughts going into the latter part of this week. So for the 22nd and 23rd, I would expect us just to kind of keep coming bearish. Yeah, I don't really see any reason why we shouldn't be getting down to the 370 zone early next week. Okay, early next week. So the 26th, 27th, Sometime by then, I would imagine we're probably down in the 370 zone and you're going to have some buying down here. You're going to have a lot of buying. I would not, do not look to go bearish in this zone. That would just be the absolute worst time to do it. The time to go bearish was up here. And if you've been with us, we were snagging right here at the top of this. So been working really well. But since we are going to get extended, if we just continue to sell off in the next few trading sessions and we just get down in the zone, maybe the next 2, 3, 4 days, we get down into this zone, that will be a very good time to just close out those bearish positions and look for a bounce higher. I'd imagine we probably retest quite a bit higher, probably up to the 390 zone, maybe 400. I don't know about the 400. But I would imagine we probably just get choppy in here for a little bit and then break down maybe late October, early November, make some yearly lows that probably hold. I don't really know if we actually break the June low here over the next week or two. It's possible if we do it, especially here, relatively short time frame. It was probably just going to get bought up. There's going to be a lot of volume sitting down here. Okay. There's going to be a lot of buyers sitting down here. Just be cognizant of that and just be paying attention to that. I'm not going to be looking to go bullish there because I'm just going to take off my bearish positions and then I'm going to see how the market sets up at that point in time. So let's talk about a little bit about what the Fed said. Just look here at the 5 minutes. So basically they came out, they raised the rates 75 basis points. You saw the market immediately react to that and traded down. And then it just kind of hung out, right? It just kind of hung out. Didn't really do too much. Then for the next 25 minutes, waited for the press conference to come out. Then the press conference started. It took off. It took 15 minutes to get back to the daily highs, make weekly highs. It didn't take too long. So it was a very nice little run that we had. Probably just freaked people out because we took weekly lows out here. And then about 30, 45 minutes later, we're taking out weekly highs. So a lot of people were probably trying to jump on. And really all we did was retest into the breakdown point of last week. Okay. And then that's where you saw the little turnaround of selling that kind of came in, a very choppy breakdown that kind of came in. But another thing that the Fed mentioned, Fed Chairman Jerome Powell mentioned in his press conference that I thought was very interesting to hear, was one of the members of the press that was there asked that if the real estate market continues to deteriorate, is the Fed going to reduce its shrinking of the balance sheet? So the other thing that the Fed is doing right now, besides just raising the Fed funds rate, is they have been selling off assets that they've been holding since June. And they've been doing this at a very high pace. And there's been some reports and some articles, if you pay attention, that have been coming out about the treasury markets, that there's just a lack of liquidity out there. And these markets that they're talking about, there's a lack of liquidity. This has a lot more, these are markets are a lot larger than the stock market. I know retail people, they focus on the stock market. A lot of people talk the stock market, but looking at the treasury market and some of those currency markets, those are much more liquid and they're much larger than the stock market. So when these people are talking, there's a lack of liquidity and they're seeing some real issues, that is something to pay attention to. So very interesting to kind of hear him say that even though if they continue to see deterioration in the real estate market, basically his answer was, we have no plans and we have not thought about stopping our sell-off of assets, okay? He made that pretty blunt clear. He didn't put as much emphasis as I am putting on that because I don't think too many people realize the ramifications that his answer basically had, okay? That was a very indicative, like, hey, we are going to continue to sell off assets. And, you know, if liquidity in the financial markets continues to get worse, we haven't thought about that. And it's not really a concern to us. We are going to continue to sell off assets. That is something that continues to just tell me to be bearish. I wouldn't be looking to be bullish in any reason. But when we get down here, there's going to be a lot of people trying to buy. I would be not looking to buy. I would just be patient. Okay. I think we're just going to beam directly down into the zone, probably get just below 370 and start looking for, you know, the takeoff of the bearish positions. Just kind of wait. If we break down, let me just kind of do this. If we just break down, we get down here and chop and then we break down, look for the retest into here and then the rollover later. If we get down here and then we bounce and make it to 390, I'm going to reload right here. I'm going to reload around that 390, upper 380s, and then it'll probably just be a slow chop down later October, November, that kind of thing. So it's probably just going to be a choppy, something like that. So that's what I'm going to look to do, but I would not be looking to be bearish in that zone. You know, there's going to be a lot of fighting. And we might wick below, you know, if we get down to the actual lows that we had in June, on June 17th, the low was 360, 217. So if we get down to that low and actually break it guys, I wouldn't be bearish. Like if we get down there pretty soon, I wouldn't be bearish. Like there's going to be buyers under that level. So just be very cautious about trying to be bearish in that zone. There's going to be buyers. Okay. But really, we're not that far from it. I mean, we had a pretty good breakdown today after the Fed talked. We were up like 0.5% before the announcement. We're only 4% away from those lows. And we just went down 1.75% today. So if we go down 1.5% tomorrow, if we go down 0.5% Friday, trade down another 1.5% on Monday, like we're roughly there, right? We're roughly there. We're not far from those levels. And really the 370 zone, you know, if we want to look at that, that's not that far. It's only 1.8% away. So, I mean, that's easily doable in a day. I mean, we just went down 1.75% today. So yeah, I mean, that's not far. We're not far from that. So don't think that that's like hugely far away. Like we're getting down there. We've seen a lot of people trying to buy the dip. You see news articles come out about retail investors trying to buy the dip during all this. Yeah, I mean, they're buying the dip and they're hurting the whole way down. So eventually they're going to stop trying to buy the dip and they're just going to let it fall down to a level where they know it's going to go to. So that's kind of the SPY. Q's probably not much different. Apple, just so you know, Apple this week, Monday, Tuesday, just absolutely crushing it strong. But really all it did was pull into the upper ends of this downward trending channel it's kind of in right now. So it's just kind of in the middle area, but it's just still downward trending. But yeah, Monday, Tuesday was really strong bullish action. That was just kind of interesting, really outperforming the market in a lot of ways over the Monday and Tuesday trading days. But let's take a look at some of the other indicators like the DXY. The DXY exploded today, okay? And it actually started taking off this morning before the Fed even came out. But you see the Fed action, you know, the pop, the drop, and then, you know, the climb back up. But it was moving bullish even before then. The TNX, the rates, they popped initially. They made another high, took out yesterday's high, but kind of coming down a little bit. Might consolidate in here before pushing back higher. Or that might have been the top, honestly, on the TNX and the 30-year rates. We'll have to just wait and see. But as far as, yeah, I mean, that might have been it. You know, you see a very nice solid pop on the 15-minute time frame, and then last hour just really kind of settling down on the TNX there. The 10-year and the 2-year inversion got a little bit more steep today as it really broke down. And you really want to see what drove that. I mean, obviously the 10-year got crushed, but man, if you look at the 2-year yield, and it popped hard today and it came back down a little bit, but man, look at that pop on the 2-year. So yeah, it's getting up over 4% now, which yeah, that's that's a pretty strong move that it's had over the past 2 weeks. So you definitely got to be paying attention to that. The GLD, just kind of hanging out for the most part. Obviously it's going to be pretty volatile when the DXY, the dollar index, is just absolutely bonkers today. But looking at the 15-minute intraday chart, I mean, you just see it just all over the place. If the dollar continues to be strong, look out for gold and GLD projects continue to go lower. The HYG making a new low week over week, you know, last Friday's low that got bought up, took that out, but kind of climbed back higher by the end of the trading session and didn't hold lower, but definitely is getting to the lows of the year. So you got to be careful on the HYG. Might see some buying kind of coming in there. And as far as the VIX had some huge spikes today, especially into the bullish direction, but still hasn't really gotten some closes over the over some of these wicks. You know, we just wicked up over 30. You really wanted to see, I was kind of talking about this past week on the Outlook video. You really want to see it spike up, get up over this 30 level, but it didn't hold, which was pretty surprising. But yeah, it was all over the place, especially right there. You see when the Fed kind of made its announcement of 75 basis points, I was really kind of surprised that it spiked that much. I kind of figured that would have been known already, but yeah, it was kind of going bonkers there for a little bit and then kind of normalized out. But what's interesting about the VIX here is it's not really holding higher. And the SPY is not that far from the yearly lows. So this thing might start to trade kind of like in the bearish direction, right? It might start to come down here on the near term. And as the market gets to its yearly lows, its annual lows down here, you might see the market start to bounce as the VIX possibly starts to fall and just continues to consolidate, because this spike was pretty nasty. A lot of people try to buy puts. You saw that right when the Fed made its announcement, but this thing might just trade lower, even though the SPY continues to trade lower as well into the zone and finds a good little bottom here and then starts to shoot back higher. That'll probably really drop the VIX, probably back down to the 23 at least level, probably a little lower. So that's really all I got for you. I wanted to keep it as short as I could, but give you the good stuff, the good information, what really happened today. But look for the SPY to make a run to its yearly lows, probably here really quick on the short term. If it does it on Friday, I'm going to be kind of bummed because I'm not going to really be able to watch it, but I'll manage what I can. So have a great rest of your week and weekend, and I will talk to y'all next week. And hopefully the apocalypse hasn't happened. Alrighty, take care, Alpha Hunters.